Chiefs Kingdom into the sweet neck of the end zone. 40-yard bomb. Yes. Touchdown, Green Bay.
Performance by Daniel Jones. And it's no good. He missed it. And the Giants win their first game of the season.
That's it, Danny Dimes. Get money. Welcome back to First Take. We're coming to you live above the Chase River Deck here at Pier 17. Thanks for hanging with us. How about Patrick Mahomes led the high-octane Chiefs to an impressive 33-28 win over the Ravens? Mahomes was doing his thing and now joins Tom Brady as the only players in NFL history with 300 pass yards, 3 pass TDs, and 0 interceptions in 3 straight games. After the game, Travis Kelce had high praise for both teams.
That's a hell of a team that just came in here. They're special. They make plays left and right. Even when it seems like their backs are against the wall, man, I'm just proud of our guys, you know, fighting till the end. It starts up top. I mean, Coach Andy Reid, all offseason, we're working on finish. Every single quarter, and sure enough, every single game, and that's what we did today.
Mahomes is a great competitor. He made some great plays today, but we gave him some big plays as well with just mental errors.
Both the Chiefs and the Ravens, the real deal. What a game. Ryan Clark back with us again, but this question is for you, Max. Has Patrick Mahomes surpassed Brady, Brees, and your boy Aaron Rodgers?
Yes, obviously. By the way, we're not talking career accomplishments. Like stay off my timeline, which is really begging for it, right? Because I'm not comparing their careers. You can't. This guy's in his second season as a starter. I'm talking about right now. Has Patrick Mahomes proved he's the best quarterback in football? Duh. He's the reigning MVP. He really proved it last year. 50 touchdowns and 12 interceptions, a 12-4 record, and it should have been an appearance in the Super Bowl as a first-year starter. So how did he follow that up? Oh, I don't know. They're 3-0. He has 10 touchdowns, no interceptions. He's leading the league in touchdowns, interceptions, yards per attempt, yards per catch, quarterback rating, yards period. He's leading the world in everything. You know why? Because he's better than everyone else. Now, will he win the Super Bowl? I mean, part of that's on Andy Reid. Maybe the answer is no. Andy Reid's never won a Super Bowl. He's a great coach whose clock management at the end isn't always great, who has been outcoached by Bill Belichick in the past. Bill Belichick still coaches the Patriots, who have a better team top to bottom right now. But in terms of quarterback play, guys, he's like the best of Aaron Rodgers meets the best of Brett Favre, only he's in his second season as a starter. He's the reigning MVP, and if you had to give out an MVP right now, you would give it to him, obviously, clearly, and by far. There's no one close. And he just did it against a Ravens defense that gave him problems last year. Stop the foolishness. Of course, Patrick Mahomes is not only the best quarterback and football player in the world, he is the single most important athlete in American team sports right now.
Well, Max would say that because Max is allergic to closing. That's not what he does. He leaves that to other people. And that's really what this comes down to. I'm not going to question the greatness of Patrick Mahomes. Excuse me. We let you speak. Let me speak. And this ain't about Mariano Rivera, who retired a few years ago. This is about now. And the fact of the matter is, when you look at Patrick Mahomes, again, talent, from a talent perspective, we understand how real he is. But forgive me, because I'm focusing on something different. I want to see you close. You know, that AFC Championship game that they almost won, I recall a first half in which they got shut out. I recall a first half in which they had 32 yards on 4 drives. I recall a first half that, you know, obviously when we look at a guy like Kareem Hunt, who found himself on the commissioner's exempt list, I believe if it were not for him, if he were playing, the Kansas City Chiefs would not only have been in the Super Bowl, but they would have won the Super Bowl. But the fact of the matter is, it didn't happen. And it's not like Brady's retired. It's not like Drew Brees is retired. It's not like they've fallen off so much that ultimately they're just there and receiving accolades and all of this other stuff before, you know, their swan song is finally sung and they go into the twilight. The bottom line is that if Drew Brees were healthy right now, Drew Brees would be in the lineup and the Saints would be a Super Bowl contender, which they are. The New England Patriots with Tom Brady are the reigning defending Super Bowl champions, who, by the way, still has a quarterback in Tom Brady. That's balling. So when we look at the individual talent of Patrick Mahomes, while I respect it, appreciate it, and in no way am trying to deny his greatness, all I'm saying is, you know how I am, Molly, about resume, and you know how I am about closing. And at the end of the day, with that talent and with that offense and with that coaching, close the deal, Patrick Mahomes, because I'm not having this conversation about Patrick Mahomes until I see that chip. That's
Stephen
me.
A. Stephen A., I don't know where you are right now or where you, woke up, but clearly the L.A. breeze was too much for you. And when you got the rundown, you said, okay, let me figure out a way that I can make this sound like Patrick Mahomes is not better than these dudes, because that's the easy part. What Max said was the easy part. I'm going to take it a step farther. Patrick Mahomes is better than all these dudes ever were. I'm talking 2007 Tom Brady, 2011 and 2015 Aaron Rodgers, Drew Brees in 2011. All of their greatest years, the greatest they've ever been, they've never been as good as Patrick Mahomes. And everybody knows how I feel about Aaron Rodgers. I watched Aaron Rodgers do things not only on film, not only in my post-career life, I'm talking about in person, that I had never seen a quarterback do. And I've seen Patrick Mahomes do those things and then do more. Patrick Mahomes plays football like a great dunker. What happens is great dunkers, when you look at the Zions and the Jordans and the Levines and Dominique Wilkins, they start out with a talent level that nobody else has. And they're so talented, they start to try to do different things. And then they put it between their legs. Then they go from the free throw line. Patrick Mahomes is inventing new ways to play quarterback. And then if you go back to last year when he did have double-digit interceptions but 50 touchdowns, you might have said, you know what? He doesn't protect the ball like Brady has, or he doesn't protect the ball like Rodgers has or Brees has. Now he threw three games, he has no interceptions, and it's not like he's not taking chances. And then it was, well, he has Tyreek Hill, but then we see Sammy Watkins show us why he was picked fourth, because he's with Pat Mahomes. And DeMarcus Robinson, another guy who no one's talking about, who's making one-handed catches, getting catches in 50-50 traffic, because Patrick Mahomes is putting the ball where nobody else can get it. And Mecole Hardman, the guy you go draft because you don't know if Tyreek Hill is going to play. We're hitting him down the seams with balls that get 8 yards off the ground and travel 40 yards down the field. That is that Brett Favre stuff. That is that Aaron Rodgers stuff. But on the other side of that, this is a guy that can move and create plays outside of the pocket, unlike Brees can do, unlike Tom Brady can do. And I know when you start talking about the greats and what they've accomplished, and you compare somebody that's new to the block like Patrick Mahomes, people want to get upset and historians want to get mad, like Stephen A., and talk about these people's resume. I don't care about their resumes. I care about when I watch it and I see him make a throw, I go, Drew can't do that. Tom can't do that. Aaron can probably do it, but he's the only one. And when that starts to happen, that's when you know that he's not only surpassed him now. That's an easy question. We know if you're starting a team now and it's just for this year, you take Patrick Mahomes over all these dudes.
But that's not where I'm going. The fact of the matter is, you didn't hear me question the greatness of Patrick Mahomes. What I said is, I want to see him close. And I'll bring up the basketball analogy you just alluded to. I don't give a damn what great person you point to. At the end of the day, we ask, when did they close? And all I'm saying is that I don't want to hear all of that without the closing, because I'm not looking at Patrick Mahomes.
The reason I went to Duncan,
I'm looking at what you're talking about. You brought up Marcus Robinson with the one-handed catches. We saw Sammy Watkins. We know Travis Kelce is the best tight end in football. You have the greatness of Andy Reid as a coach, play calling, and all of this other stuff, even though there's some questions in terms of big moments. The bottom line is, there's things around him, not just his greatness, but there's things around him that eradicate the excuses. I know he's great, but I want
we can't question Andy Reid. We can't question Andy Reid's ability to close and Andy Reid's ability to get things done in the biggest moments, and then put it on Patrick Mahomes. We want to see
If Patrick Mahomes starts winning championships, then he's validating what Ryan is saying, which he's already the best to ever do it. I'm saying right now he's better than everyone else. If he does the things you're talking about, then I'm with Ryan. Then look, he's already, he's proved he's the best to ever do. But you bring up closing. You said he struggled in the first half, but what happened in the second half of that
he
game?
Came back.
So he came on in the second half
almost
of the game.
Delivered it. Yes, he did.
In the AFC Championship game, if not for a pre-snap penalty, they beat Bill Belichick, Tom Brady, and the Patriots.
Performing in the first half, they would have blown them out.
Okay, but if you're looking for clues, right? Because right now we don't have all the evidence that the other guys have. If you're looking for clues, is this dude a closer? You want him to? If he's not going to ball in one half,
I'm
first
not
or
questioning
second,
it.
He balled in
I'm
the second
saying
half.
I demand it. I'm not questioning, and that's the difference between me and y'all. I'm not questioning it. I'm saying I demand it. I know what you can do because I know what your talent says. But if we're going to hold everybody else accountable to get it done, I'm saying with Patrick Mahomes. You're that great. You're that much of a stud. Get it done. Yep. I don't want to have a conversation about how great you are compared to everybody else when you have a coach.